So here is, again, northern horizon. Here is Polaris, or North Celestial Pole. Big Dipper at one moment. Here is the Big Dipper 6 hours later. It has moved in 6 hours from this location to this location. How big is this angle? It's 90 degrees. At the same time, in the southern hemisphere, there is, you see, South Celestial Pole, somewhere here. But there is no star that is located very close to the South Celestial Pole. We are fortunate that we live at times where there happens to be a star, the North Star or Polaris, that is very close to the location of the North Celestial Pole. Nothing like that in the southern hemisphere. In this case, we can use this constellation, so-called Southern Cross. To actually locate the South Celestial Pole. And just a matter of taking the longer axis of the Southern Cross and multiplying it several times, I forget now the number, how you can mark the location of the South Celestial Pole. Of course, it used to be important in the past for people who were sailing. They needed to know their bearings, to know where they are going and where they are. Now we live in times of GPSs, right? So you can buy a very good a GPS for about $100 that can determine your location on Earth very precisely to within the few meters, okay? But if you drop a GPS overboard, then you have to be able to still navigate, know where you are. Now, in the southern hemisphere, you can see this is, say, a Southern Cross now, and it's moving now clockwise. And in 6 hours, it would be located here. Again, in 6 hours, the angular displacement would be 6 times 15 degrees, 90 degrees. Now, there is an actual, I have a photograph, I'm sure there are many more available. It's very neat. It was obtained by photographing the sky using a very long exposure. So that if you make a very long exposure, then stars would actually mark the lines on photographic plate. So you can actually see their trajectories, the paths that they describe on the sky. And you can see here that all of these stars are circumpolar stars, right? They are all moving around a North Celestial Pole, moving counterclockwise in beautiful circular paths that you know are parallel to the celestial equator. And if they are sufficiently close to the North Celestial Pole, they're always visible. They're always above horizon, and such stars are called circumpolar stars. Those stars never rise or set, they're always above the horizon.